and I'll do the carrots, and
we can do the potatoes. Kiri, do you want to do the potatoes in that bed?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's on this front of the bed. We can get all the seed trays ready, and I'll do the...
And it's good that you picked the potatoes to go into the middle, because it's the less blightiest part of the whole tunnel, like, you know, it's
apparently... You're going to be spraying it, huh?
Huh?
We're going to ask you to spray it.
Of course, like, but what I'm saying
every
is,
week,
like,
yeah,
for example, near the doors is usually where the blight happens, you know?
Yeah. You're going to have to watch out for the old blight, though. Yeah. In this world
of give and take. So let's see the carrots.
So the carrot seeds. These are the carrot seeds. Autumn King.
Okay.
We basically seed saved these just from last year's crop.
Excellent.
You know, we selected maybe 5 or 6 really big carrots. You know, we decided to take them,
right,
and then sow them. You know.
Cool. So you're making your drills.
Yeah. So. What I'm trying to do here is we want to kind of try and get this whole bed full of carrots, so
yeah,
we have a nice big crop and an early crop as well, you know?
Cool.
But you know as well, when you're taping away, just cut out a lot of the shite.
I'm going to include that last bit now, man. Well, that's a kind of a good trick that the people do, you know, when they're seeding into drills, is they add sand in with the seeds. So if they wanted to go in thinner, because there's sand in with the seeds, they naturally do fall in thinner, you know.
I get you.
It's a cool little technique.
And here what you would do is you'd make sure that they're buried by about the same height of soil, you know?
Really?
So maybe 1.5 or 2 times the height
really?
Of the seed
with the carrot, yeah?
Well, no, with everything.
Oh, with everything?
Any kind of seed, yeah.
Oh.
That's how you know how to, you know, how deep to bury it.
Yeah, okay. What we refer to as maturity. From emotional need to technology. As you were caught to a seed of your society. Like inability to feel clemency. I'm surprised you still.
What are you doing now, anyway?
I'm putting in a few, the Tibetan. They're from Tibet. And they are high resistance to disease and blight.
All right, yeah.
So that's why we picked them, because we have such a small space.
Yeah.
And then we can't really be bringing in any diseases or blight, because it'll affect the whole population. And we have nothing.
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 Nothing compares.
Nada. Oh, it's just some runners.
Brought away anyway. It's too cold for them to germinate, is it?
Not
to worry.
Right. They need at least 15 degrees centigrade, is it, before they can...
Oh, I'd say about 20 or something,
20
yeah.
Runners, yeah.
Centigrade, yeah. People deal with Fahrenheit here in this country, don't they?
Yeah, centigrade.
Centigrade now, isn't it? Yeah.
Well, you always do centigrade.
Oh, did you?
Yeah,
I thought it was Fahrenheit.
No, we won't do that. That's the Americans.
All right. So that'd be great now. So I suppose you'll earth them up now once they come up a bit, huh?
Yeah. Good few worms in here.
So your channel is Your Gardens, is it?
Yeah,
oh, yeah.
Your Gardens, and it's at the moment Your Gardens is taking a new theme.
Yeah, great.
It's still gardening, but it's my old style of gardening, which was the, we'll say, the busy landscapers type of gardening.
Yeah.
Really, just give the customer what they want, but it's good news these days that the customer is starting to think a little differently. Customer these days, we like a garden with a purpose instead of a garden that eats
or competes with the Joneses next door, you know?
Yeah, I know what you mean, yeah.
So
yeah.
The people, they want a garden that looks alright, but you can also grow some choices. And it gets the children out into the garden too, helping out, you know? And they get rewards at the end of the year and see the open.
Exactly,
you know,
yeah.
An empty landscape, yeah. You know, at least there's something to look forward to. And the good thing about
and kids love growing vegetables, like especially the younger ones, you know. Yeah.
And they love the taste of it, you know. Whereas like kids, you know, especially in Cork City or in cities, urban areas,
yeah,
they think vegetables is made in factories, you know. A lot of them do.
You heard about the pink cow, did you? Did you ever hear about the pink cow? You know the milk ad, pink,
yeah.
The pink chocolate. There was a 10-year-old German boy,
yeah.
And he thought that actually cows were not pink, purple.
Right.
Because he saw them on the ads, like,
right.
You know? It's
yeah.
Incredible, like. Right.
Huh?
Scary, like, you know?
It's pretty similar, right?
Yeah, yeah, go.
Do you know what strawberry milkshakes?
Yeah.
So I heard some people thought that the cow ate strawberries.
Ah, no, really?
And then they had strawberry milk.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Which is kind of cute.